Welcome back to another video. Today we've got the Goodman's action camera. This reminds me of the GoPro, and I saw it in the shops and I was like, this looks interesting, because in the package it's in this like case, survival case I think it is. It shows in the back. No, it's like a protective case, yeah, waterproof housing, I see. And then I saw it and I was like, is this any good, do you think? And I was like, let's see. So this is what I'm going to be unboxing today, and I'll test it out as well. So make sure you stay tuned to the end of the video so I can show you the footage and just generally see how good this performs. Before we start, the last video that I have done, I've got so much I got so much support on that. It's unbelievable. I think currently now, we recorded this like I think 2 weeks ago, and it's already got 254 views, and that's impressive. I was like, what? And every day it just keeps going up. So we're gonna hope for the best for this one. Make sure you like and comment on what I can improve on, because from now on I'm gonna be recording with that camera. And make sure you like and just stay tuned for more tech videos, because I've got lots of things planned, but I have to make time for it. So enough chatting, let's get into it. There was like little circle, you know them circle tapes. I already took that off. Oh, it's that plastic thing. So this is the camera. So get to the side here. And I think there's the mounts in there. Wait, let's shake it. No, it's not coming out. No. Okay, I'll get that out later. But this is the camera. That's kind of cool. So let me take out the packaging. Here's the camera, and what's this? Wait, we'll look at that after, but first impressions, not bad. Oh, we still got plastic on it. We'll take that off after, but this is the case. What's this? Lots of buttons. Oh, it turned on. It made a noise. Did you hear that? Oh my god, there's... So you have to put an SD card in, but there's a display in the back. Wait, it did say this, didn't it? It said... Where is it? LCD display. How big is it? 2 inches, I think. Yeah, 2-inch LCD display. Whoops. But here it is. It's saying no card. I'll put a card in later. And on camera, it looks blue, but it looks really good in real life. And it's got low battery. So this is probably gonna turn, yep, turned off. I'm gonna put this on charge and we'll see what's in the other boxes. Wait, let's see if the charger is in here, because it did say it. So I got the white box out. Did come with the charge. No, wait, what's this? I thought I was a charger for a second. Wait, we'll get into that later. I think that's a strap. Here's the charger. And it's a USB-C, I'm guessing. Because everything's USB-C. Yep. So we'll put that there. And I'll put that on charge. But let's see what else is in here. What is this? We've got the mounts, because it did say it comes with 5 mounts, so that's for that. But inside, so we could take it off, another mount, and another mount, and a manual. We'll probably look at that, and another one of them. Oh wait, I think this stands on top of each other. I think Wait, so this put also an attachment. Another piece of paper in here. Oh, it's the guarantee in that. We don't need to look at that. And another, oh my gosh, so much in here. User manual, so I'm gonna need that. Yeah, so it says all of the things that come inside. USB charge, yeah, USB charging cable, waterproof case, securing latch, camera shield, attachment buckle, handle. Well, basically all of this is here. Before I put it on charge, I just need to show you this. And don't lie and say that wasn't satisfying. And there's one here as well. Whoa, the camera looks nice. It looks proper shiny. Okay, so now I'm gonna put it on charge. The Goodman's, well, the GoPro replica, should we say, because replicas aren't always good, and this camera was terrible. I didn't expect it. I had really high hopes for it because it just looked aesthetically, it looked like a GoPro, and I think I was getting a bit too ahead of myself, because on the LCD I saw like the footage and it was worse than what's on the screen at the moment, but I was like, it's probably because of the LCD, it's like not going to be amazing. And I loaded it onto the computer and I was like, no, because now on the screen you can see that in the morning it's so washed out, but at night it's not as washed out. I think it's because of the sunset, it picks out more colours. But now look, you can see the branches, it's not even worth looking at, it's terrible. But you can see that, look, and it just struggles with the sky. But now, if you take a look, this is, just keep in mind, this is an iPhone 6 that's been used heavily day to day, and the camera quality is way better. Like, there's a price difference, I understand, but an iPhone is not specialized in a camera, it's a smartphone, whereas the other was a camera, nothing else. And if you just look at the branches, I'm going to zoom in and you can see it's not washed out. Look at that, it's still got detail. It maintains the detail, look at that. And even when we zoom in to the far distance,
you can still see it is not washed out. And if you just compare it one-on-one, you can see the massive differences. And if you go to the sky, it's not like that black and white thing.
Well, the camera had potential, but obviously in this case, it didn't perform. The last earbuds did well, so I think that's 1-1, one good, one bad. But that's it for this one. Join us for the next one, because I've got headphones coming, wireless against wired in 2018. We'll see how it goes. I'm very cold. Catch you on the next one. Bye.